Hello, my name is Cliff. Thank you for joining me for another one of my videos. I'm one of those people on here on YouTube talking about the return of Jesus Christ. This is a video about symbols. The title of this collection of videos is 99 Problems But My God Ain't One. But I want to talk about the hidden messages or hidden signals in symbols and logos, corporation logos, corporation signs. There's all kinds. Like everywhere you see, there's messages in symbols and signs. The elite or the hidden agents use these things to communicate between each other. In all industries, there are signs. Every facet of our lives, there's hidden signals that we don't recognize out in the normal public, but they are the evil signs of Satan, and these are used by the rich.
People who don't know, who runs the Illuminati? Who are the founding fathers of this whole demonic?
What I do is, rather than talk off the top of my head, is your dollar back. At the top of my head, I go to books like this, Bloodlines of the Illuminati. It gives you all of the families that are here, not written by a black man, not written by Griff. You understand what I'm saying? These are the bloodlines of the Illuminati. This is why Barry, Barack Obama, President Obama, is tied in via the bloodline. This is why Jay-Z said that he was sitting in Saint-Tropez sipping $20,000 bottles of Cristal with the Blue Bloods. Are you following me? So when you talk about a place like the White House, they're not talking about a physical place, they're talking about a bloodline. So we can call their names all day long, but until you connect the dots that Steve Coakley teaches us, you don't know who's operating with who. All right, so Fritz Springmeier broke it down in this book, The Bloodlines of the Illuminati. And the average person, especially us, we're not going to go to the store and spend $40 and decode this and break this down and teach this to our people. But brothers like myself, I have to. And this gentleman, Tex Mars, wrote Codex Magica. All these signs and symbols and these handshakes and all this kind of stuff your man Jay-Z and the rest of these people are doing, they're decoded right in this particular book. They don't position themselves with these handshakes and these body movements and sitting a certain way. You see what I mean? They don't do this for nothing. Alright? They do this for a reason. Look. Are you following me? They're speaking a language to someone right past your consciousness. They're speaking an entire language. And until we become symbol literate,
I definitely want to get
we won't know Codex Magica by Tex Mars.
I'll make sure y'all check this out. I mean, like this glance, because you know he was showing me a lot of things. It's like all the different poses and stuff people do.
Right, and handshakes and whatnot. We got to understand why these people sit the way they do and send signals the way they do. And the whole language that they use, being a symbol literate. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We got to understand that, because they're speaking the language right past us. A lot of people ask me, matter of fact, Tavis Smiley asked me in my book when the cameras were turned off. He said, because I came to the interview on the Tavis Smiley show, with books and newspapers and shit. He says, well, you can leave that backstage. I'm like, nah, I might need it. So I just kind of set it right there on the coffee table. But they made sure they didn't get it in the shot. Because if he would go in on some of these things, I wanted to show them that this is not coming from me. God is no respecter of persons, man. God don't care who you are. The truth is the truth. Listen, if it starts to rain right now and all of us went outside, you think it's not going to rain on you like it's going to rain on me? God is no respecter of persons. When the truth hits you, it hits you.
So what is Illuminati's purpose in the industry, and when did they infiltrate the industry? Well, when did this all start in the industry as far as music?
Well, globally, they want a total global enslavement. They want to control every facet of everyone's life, everything moving, breathing, thinking. They want to control everything on the planet.
So what is Illuminati's purpose in the industry, and when did they infiltrate the industry? Well, when did this all start in the industry as far as music?
Well, globally, they want a total global enslavement. They want to control every facet of everyone's life. Everything moving, breathing, thinking. They want to control everything on the planet.
The rich elite are the ones that are orchestrating this demise of the world. It's been going on for decades, even centuries. So as we were born into this web of lies and deceit, and we have grown up amongst them, and so we don't know that they're actually there because things are normal. And even in today's day and age, even though things are rapidly moving forward for the elite and their evil and wicked plan, they are coming out in front of our eyes. They are exposing themselves because they are ready to complete their plan. One other reason for them coming out and exposing themselves is to make everything seem normal. Normal is the thing of the world. It's always been that way. The easier it is to pull things over your eyes if you believe this is the way they are always. But in other words, if you believe that it's the right to kill another man, you will do it because it's in your system. It's in your belief. It's in your trust. But a part of you does know this is not the truth, whatever you may believe in your mind. Your spirit, your soul, is supposed to know this is wrong. And those that actually go against the spirit at times find this out with illnesses normally known as post-traumatic stress syndrome. Now, the elite of the world have created a mask that has been pulled over your eyes, a web, a big maze that you are never supposed to understand because of your place in the world. You're one of the little ones or little people, the workers, the wasters. They have many names for you, but you are not one of them, the Illuminati, the elite, the rich and famous. Many of these people are the ones that are orchestrating our demise. Nearly everything is in a display of power. Corporation use everywhere. The knowledge of this stuff comes from school. The universities in the U.S. Incorporate these people through initiation. These signs use the serpent, the devil, the eye of Horus, and the sun of Iris on a constant basis. This is their normal practice. The rich are the ones that are allotted to using these signs because they are the ones that communicate through these signals to know who are they represent. In other words, the enemy Satan. The lower class people can elevate to this status, to the elite status, by earning their way into the ranks, by earning money and then sort of buying their way in and becoming first a puppet of the elite or a puppet of these factions.
They use these signals or these signs to communicate with each other. The Illuminati, Freemasons, they're all agents of these type of factions. The scary thing about all these signs and signals is they are used in high order institutions, the ones that we believe are factions that are here to help us and here to protect us. Nothing could be further from the truth. If you look, you notice that the snake or the serpent is a common use in these designs. Another representation of these signs are the pyramid of order or the pyramid of education, pyramid of rank, where Satan sits on top of the pyramid and his soldiers rank below him. Every major company in this world is started to or has already changed their logos to fit this design, the pyramid. Some of these designs have two methods where they can work in sideways or flat. The Freemasons is one of these groups that run through the Illuminati. A lot of these signs are also used as sun worship. You'll see the circle, and the sun is their use of worship. All this is done to anger the Lord God. Here you'll see Moloch in his representation, the owl, which is another god that the Illuminati pray to or worship. And everything is used and held under an umbrella. Another is the all-seeing eye, the eye of Horus. And here's a representation of it in secret. There's another one as well with AOL. Here you'll see some of the most deceiving things and wondrous things that you'll ever notice. If you fold any dollar bill of the United States in a pentagram design, you'll see the events that have happened or are coming to happen in the future. And there's no denying what these symbols actually look like.
All this information is very hard to believe because it's all this stuff has always been there. It's always been right in front of our faces. That's why if somebody tells you this stuff, you're not going to believe it. You have to investigate this stuff for yourself. The best way to do it, in my opinion, is to get down on your knees and ask the Lord to speak to you in your prayers. Is this the truth? And let Him tell you, you're not supposed to trust man. But you're supposed to trust the Lord.